Do you ever wish you could keep parts of your web browsing separate? As an example, maybe you'd like to keep your work and personal browsing separate? Well, you can do this with Safari Profiles, which was introduced in macOS Sonoma. Each profile can be customized with its own set of favorite bookmarks and extensions. They also have their own history. Let's take a look at how we can create and manage these profiles in Safari on the Mac. Now, before we dive any further, if you find this video helpful, make sure to watch till the end. I'll share a little bit more about myself and how you can support my efforts in bringing you these tutorials. All right, let's get back to our topic and delve deeper into Safari profiles. So what are profiles and why would I want to use them? Well, basically, Safari profiles are a feature in the Safari web browser. This works on the Mac, iPad, and iPhone. We're just going to look at the Mac here. But basically what it does is it allows you to create separate browsing environments. It might be better if I show you on my Mac. When we go over to Safari here, you're going to see I have three different windows open. Each one of these is a different profile. So I have here my personal profile. And then you're going to see I have a profile for Beth. And then I also have a profile for my business. So each one of these is a separate browsing environment. What do I mean by that? Well, if we look here at my favorites, you're going to see that this is set up for my dance tutorials favorites. This is my business profile. But then when we go over to Beth, she could have her own favorites. And then if we go over to my personal account, I have my own favorites. So they're going to have their own favorite bookmarks folder. On top of that, they're going to have their own history. So when we go to my history up here, you're going to see that this profile here has quite a bit of history. I recently created Beth's profile here, so we do not have a lot of history. So each environment has their own favorites folder as well as their own history. On top of that, we can customize the start page for each one. If we look here, you're going to see that Beth has a privacy report. But if we go to the profile for my business, I do not have the privacy report. They can also have their own extensions. If we go over to my personal account here, my personal profile, you're going to see that I have an extension for Downy. I can download videos. But when we go over to Beth's profile here, that is not there. So it's almost like these profiles are their own browser. They're going to have their own history. They're going to have their own favorite bookmarks. They're going to have their own start page. They're going to have their own extensions. They're also going to have their own cookies and cash. So what I'd be able to do is log into my business PayPal account here and also log into my personal PayPal account here. And guess what Beth would be able to do? Log into her PayPal account here. Again, it's like you're having three different browsers, but it's all within Safari. So you're still within the Apple ecosystem. All of this is going to sync across all your different devices. All of your passwords are going to work across all of your different devices. All you're doing is just kind of creating an environment for each one of these profiles. Beth gets on the computer, she can see her favorites. She can see her history. I get on my computer for business, I can see my history, my business history. I can see my business favorites. And then when I go to personal, I can see my personal favorites with my personal history. Again, all within Safari. So that is what profiles are. You can use them to separate your browsing from business to personal, as well as for other people that get on your computer. So now let's see how we set this up. What I'm going to do is delete these profiles, and then we're going to start from scratch so you can actually see how this all works. So to set this up, what we do is we go up to Safari in the menu bar, and then from here we go over to our settings. Select it. And then we go over to profiles. Under profiles, you're going to see we have all of the different profiles. So I'm just going to go ahead and delete these. So this is the first thing we're going to learn is how we can delete these. So I just select the one I want to delete, click on the minus, and it's going to delete that profile. We're going to do this with Beth as well. So now I've just deleted those profiles. I only have one profile. Now let's go and recreate this. I'm going to recreate the business profile. So I go back up to my Safari settings here, and then we go over to profiles. I click on start using profiles. First thing I need to do is I need to name it. So I'm just going to call this business. We're going to apply this icon here. and I'm going to apply the blue color. From here, I can also select what bookmarks folder I want to use. I have a folder within my bookmarks called Dance Tutorials. So I'm just going to go use existing folder, and we're just going to select Dance Tutorials. And now I just create the profile. And now that profile has been created. You can see it over here, and it opened up a new window. Now from here, what I'm able to do is select which extensions I want to use in this profile. I'll just go through here and select which ones I want to use. And I can also deselect the ones I don't want to use. So let's just say I didn't want to use this one. I just deselect it. That extension will no longer be available with that profile. That's how easy it is. So now let's go and create one more. We're going to create Beth. So I just go under the plus here. And then I type in Beth. And I'm going to give her a different icon. So we're just going to click on the three pluses here. We'll just give her a smiley face. And I'm going to go with a little red color there. And with this one, what I want to do, I don't have a favorite bookmarks folder, so I'm just going to go and create one. So now I just click on Create Profile, and now we have that as well. And from here, I'm able to go and select which extensions she can use. And I can go and make other changes. So if I wanted to change the color, change the symbol, anything like that. I can also set what new windows open up with each profile. I generally leave them at the start page. So that's basically all we have to do. We can just start using these profiles. So I'm going to close this. And you can see we have Beth here. We have my business here. And we have my personal over here. So now I have my three profiles. That's basically all we have to do. When Beth gets on the computer, she'll go and open up a new browser window with Beth. If I am using business, I'll go over here to business and create or start surfing with my business profile. And it'll remember that in that profile. So how do we open up new windows and switch between these different profiles? So it's actually pretty easy. I'm just going to close these. We're going to open up a new browser window. So command N, I'm in a new browser window. So it opened up to Beth. This was the last profile that I used. So let's just say I wanted to switch over to my business profile. Beth isn't using this, so I want to switch over to my business profile. A couple different ways I can do that. What I can do is I can go over here to Beth, I click on it, and then I can switch it to a new business window. It's not going to create a new window. What it's going to do is it's going to switch this one over to a business window. So it's not a new window. I can also, let's say I didn't want to go with business, or what I'd like to do is actually open up a personal window, but I want to open it up in a new window. So now I just go back up under here, and you're going to see I can also create a new personal window. So this is going to create a new window for my personal profile. Select it, and now I have these two windows open. This is going to have its own history, and this one's going to have its own history. Now Beth wants to get on the computer. What she would do is she would either go up here and switch to her profile, or what she can do is go up under File, and then you're going to see New Window, and she would select New Beth Window. And now we have that profile open as well. So that's how we can easily switch between them. Now what about the start page? How can we modify the start page? Well, that's pretty simple. We just go to the start page here, and then you go down to the lower right-hand corner, and what you're able to do is select what you want to show in the start page. Anything that I change here is going to be applied to this profile. So let's just go ahead and turn these all off. We'll just go drastic here. And now we can see it's a blank profile. But when we go over to our blank start page, when we go over here to my profile, I create a new window. I have all of those other options in there. I can go and change this one as well. Click on this, and let's just go and take a few of these out. So now I just have my favorites here. But if I go to my personal, I have everything in there. So Beth has nothing, my business has a few things, my personal has everything. So we just go down to the bottom in the start page, and then you can go and change what you want to show. What about extensions? Well, as you saw, what I'm able to do is select which extensions show. So this is Downy. I can download videos if I want to change that. Maybe I don't want that on my personal account. Again, we just go over to Safari, Settings, and then we go over to the profile. So we'll go with Business here. I go to Extensions, and then I can turn off the extension that I no longer want to use with that profile. Now there's one catch to this. the default profile, what you have to do is you have to go to extensions to turn it off. And when you turn this off, being that this is the default profile, what it's going to do is change all of the other profiles. So if I go and add Send to Mars Edit here, this is for blogging, what it's going to do is turn that on for all of the other profiles. So now you're going to see that is on there. So if you want to mess around with the default, I would say set this one up first. And then from there, it's much easier to just go and turn off and on the extensions you want to use for each profile. Otherwise, what you have to do, if you go and change the extensions for your default profile, what you're going to have to do is go into each one of these and change the extensions. So there's a little catch to that. Much easier to set up your extensions first for the default profile, then go and modify them for your other profiles. To remove a profile, as we saw in the beginning, we just click on the minus. And also what we're able to do is delete the history and cache for a specific profile. So if I go up under Safari here, and then we want to clear the history. It's not going to clear the history for everything. When I select this, being that I have profiles, I can select which profile I want to remove the history from. So let's say Beth is having a problem with her profile. What I'm able to do is go over to Beth's profile here and clear the last hour. I can also clear today, today and yesterday, as well as all history. So we can select this for each profile. Let's take a look at that favorites. I have a couple of tips for you. Now, again, what we're able to do when we go to our settings here and we go to profiles, we can set what folder we see for our favorites. Now, this doesn't mean that each profile has their own bookmarks. Every profile can see all of the bookmarks within Safari. So it's not separating the bookmarks from each other. But what you are able to do is set a folder for the favorite bookmarks. So I can go and set a different folder for my favorite bookmarks for business here. And then I can also set a different folder for favorites for Beth. To manage this, what we do is we go over to our bookmarks. So I'm going to open up the bookmarks here. So I go to my sidebar. And then you're going to see bookmarks. Now, if you don't see this, what you'll need to do is just go down to bookmarks here. And then you can see all of your bookmarks. So, as I said, all profiles are able to see all of these bookmarks. But what we're able to do is set which ones show as favorites. So in my personal profile, these are what is shown. So I can go click on this carrot here and I can rearrange these. And now you can see it rearranged them. I can go and move some of these out. Let's just go and move CNN out here. And when I do, we can see we have CNN here. And then if I go over to my business, I have a separate folder for that. I click on the sidebar and you're going to see my favorites here. This is the folder that I designated. So now I can just click on this and I can rearrange these as well. So now I just put PayPal in front. So we just go over to our bookmarks here and we can go and rearrange them. And again, all profiles have access to all bookmarks. So even though I'm in my business profile, I still have access to my favorites from my personal. I still have access to Beth's bookmarks. So you are sharing all of the bookmarks. All you're doing is really designating which folder you want to use for your favorites. Now here's a little tip for favorites. This is one of my favorite things to do with Safari. What we can do is we can show our favorites in the toolbar here. I love this. To do that, I'm just going to close the sidebar. What we do is we go up under View here, and then you're going to see Show Favorites Bar. When I select this, it's going to add a section to my toolbar, and you can see I have all of my favorites here. Which means when I go over to my personal, I'm just going to close this, and we're going to open up a new window. So then we can see my favorites. So I'm going to go and switch this over to my personal window. And here are my favorites for my personal. And of course, if I close this and reopen it, we're going to switch to Beth. Her favorites will be up here too. I don't have any bookmarks in her favorites. So that's a nice little tip. Just go up under View and then you can show your favorites. Now the last thing I want to show you is how you can designate a link to open up in a specific profile. Now this is for outside links. If you are linking within Safari, it really doesn't do anything. But if you click on a link that is outside of Safari, maybe it's in Messages, maybe it's in Mail, what you're able to do is tell that link, that website, to open up in a specific profile. So I'm going to go to Dan's Tutorials. I would like this link to open up in my business profile. When I click on it from Mail or Messages or anything like that, it does have to be an outside link. So I go to the website first, and then we go over to our settings, and then we go over to Websites. Under Websites, you're going to see an option for Open Links with Profile. And then from here, what we're able to do is set our currently open website to open up in a specific profile. So I want this one to open up in Business. Click on that. And now, any outside links to Dan's Tutorials, if I get an email, a message, anything like that, what it's going to do is it's going to open up in Business. Let's go and set one more. We're going to go to Naples Mug. Let's say that Beth is a member of Naples Mug. So the first thing we do is we go over to the website, and then we go to our settings. We need to go to Websites, Open Links With. You're going to see Naples Mug here. And Beth is a member, so when she clicks on a link, maybe she gets an email from them a couple times a week saying what is new or anything like that. So when she clicks on that link in the email, she would like to open up in her profile. So I select it, and now any outside links are going to open up in Beth's profile. So now let's see this in action. We're just going to close all of these windows. I have in my mail a couple of emails with outside links. This is why it's outside. It's outside of Safari. So now what I do is I go over here to Naples Mug. I have a link here. What do you think is going to happen when I click on it? It's going to open up in Beth's profile. Let's go and take a look at another email. I have another one from Dan's Tutorials. This one is going to open up in my business profile. So any outside links will open up in that respective profile. So that is what Safari profiles are. They help you create, or they help you separate your work browsing habits from your personal browsing habits, as an example. We can set what our favorite bookmarks are for them. We can set what the start page looks like. We can have outside links open up in specific profiles. Just go over to your Safari settings, and from there you'll be able to create your own profiles. So that's how we work with Safari profiles on the Mac. Now, did you like the video? Make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe. Also, you may want to share it with your friends or family. Here's a little bit about me and what I have to offer. I'm Dan Wasink. I've been creating these easy-to-follow video tutorials for your Apple devices for over a decade. You can find these videos on YouTube and on my site, danstutorials.com. With YouTube, I have over 400 videos, and on my site, I have over 2,100 videos as of this recording. I've been creating these videos a lot longer for my site than I have for YouTube. I also host webinars on a regular basis, usually about 2 to 3 a month, and I recently added an AI assistant that is modeled after a Mac Genius to my site. You can help support my efforts by becoming a member of my site, Dan's Tutorials. Members get all the videos ad-free, webinar and online classes are included, and you get access to my AI assistant. On top of that, you are helping support a small business. Check out Dan's Tutorials for more information, and thanks for watching. That's how you work with Safari profiles on the Mac.